Life without your music would be not worth living. I'd be useless.
One of the things that happened with this little version, this little non-Broadway version of Phantom, was I took a page out of the playbook of Cameron Mackintosh because I saw what he did. I thought, well, we're never going to be on Broadway, but if everybody is going to do the same show, there should be a logo. And so it wasn't terribly expensive. I found a wonderful, wonderful designer, and he did a logo that really imprinted a stamp and an image for the show. And since music printing is going to print a folio, we made sure that the piano vocal booklet that you could get for Phantom would have that logo. And we made that logo available to every regional theater production in the United States or all over the world during the show. At that stage of the game, it became very clear, and at that time we were working with Billy Rosenfield, who was a wonderful record producer and record executive. And so there we had a bona fide Broadway cast album with a huge orchestra of 30 or 35, with Jonathan conducting, fantastic choruses that cost much, much, much less. And of course, we put the logo on it. So suddenly, here is this flagship without a flagship. Normally, you have the flagship production. There's Miss Saigon. There's the helicopter. There's the piano vocal book. There's the cast album. Well, Phantom had the same without ever having to play Broadway. And I think as a result of that, it became a brand.